In a letter that was dumped near the office of the massacre resident district commissioner, the attackers also listed a number of prominent business personnel and a former member of parliament in the region, notifying them to get ready for the attack. They also told off police and its sister agencies that none of them have ever been arrested, as they lament in public. But the police have also responded with confirming that they are more than ready to crack down on anybody who would dare to cause insecurity in the region. This has, however, raised tension among the people whose names were listed together with the general public. Those whose names appeared on the list convened an abrupt meeting at the massacre resident district commissioner's office in a bid to devise means on how to have their personal security built. They called upon the businesses in the region to boost security in the but
tugenda kuongeranga bitubadde ali kati nokusingiza wodala dalala bino byo tema abantu kale nina abana inchi kati bali betegefu kubanga tubasomeseze ekimala nafe tubawadde obumala.
As one of the means to reduce the risk of being attacked, the people who are on the list have regulated the time which visitors should go to their homes, with some of them limiting it at 6 p.m. Those mentioned are still in shock, as they say they do not have any rangers. Former Masaka District Woman Member of Parliament, Freda Mubanda, whose name also appears on the list, suspects that its author had personal grudges with those listed down.
Babade nga balali kacharo naye kati balali semanya buterevu kyenvansaba abakuru abatuwa obukumi batuongeremu obukumi kw'obwaffe bwe tulina.
Southern Regional Police spokesperson Diana Nandaula has confirmed that the letters were circulated all over Masaka town. Since last year, the anonymous letters have been circulated in various parts of the Greater Masaka, and surprisingly, the attackers execute their content of those letters without being arrested. Report by Yasinta Wanika for Urban TV.